She's a Mona Lisa.
Good morning, guys. Today I decided that I want to film a day of what I do in quarantine. Right when I wake up, I can't tell if I like having my glasses on or not. I'm gonna take them off right now. I put a positive mindset into my head and then I try not to go on my phone too much. Today I slept in a lot, but normally I try to wake up early, not early, just like a decent time so that I have like a full day. But last night I stayed up pretty late, so I wanted to make sure that I'm getting enough sleep. So after I wake up and just put a positive mindset into my head, I pick up my 5-minute journal. It's like the first thing that I do, and I fill it out. So we're gonna do that right now. So I just filled out my 5-minute journal. So now that I've filled that out and kind of reflected on how I want my day to go, I'm going to go downstairs and make myself some breakfast.
Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why I'm down, yeah. No friends of mine around, yeah. Now I'm thinking I might have caught the June blues. Yeah, I wanna drown myself inside the June.
Okay, so I just finished eating my breakfast and now I'm back upstairs and I'm gonna do my online school for the day. I have my little setup over here, my laptop, and then my planner. A planner is like super important to me because I get stressed out if I don't like see everything that I need to do written out. And I love just being able to like check off each box after I do it. So I'm gonna do my online school for the day and then we'll move on to the next task. Also guys, look at all my crystals. I just recently started getting into crystals because my college roommate, Maddie, she has like so many crystals and she's super into it. And so she kind of rubbed off on me. And so I decided, like, it was during Mercury retrograde and I was just feeling horrible. And I feel like everything was being thrown off, like communication and all that, because like Mercury retrograde is known for doing that. So I ordered like all these different crystals that have different meanings and stuff, and it's seriously, I feel like it works. Like I feel like it's changed the energy around me, and it's supposed to just like cleanse you from like negative energy and negative vibes. Just wanted to tell you guys about my crystals. Now I'm gonna do my online school. Talk to you guys after I'm done.
It's not gonna be in vain, too young. Why you gotta go? Why you gotta go? I just wanna know now. True now. Crying again.
Hey guys, so I just finished my online schoolwork and then I decided to listen to a podcast after that because I wanted like something to just like kind of get my mind off of all the craziness right now and just like have something to laugh at and also like feel inspired. So I listened to a podcast and then I had a snack. I had bananas and cashew butter, which I normally don't eat cashew butter, but my mom bought it the other day and I tried it and it's actually so good. So I had that for a little snack. Now I'm going to meditate and then work out. So I'm gonna first meditate, and what I do is I just go on my phone when I get my AirPods over there and I go on YouTube and I just look up, well, I have a couple of my favorite meditations saved, but today I might do a new one that I haven't done before. So I just go on YouTube and search up like manifestation meditations or visualization, or sometimes I do like a gratitude meditation. And yeah, they're normally like, I just sit down for like 20 minutes and meditate. So let's do that.
But what about what I want? What about what I want? 'Cause what I wanted was to laugh at the way you laugh at the.
So I just finished meditating. It was really nice. And sorry, my hair looks ratchet AF right now. I just finished meditating and now I'm gonna go downstairs and do a little workout. If you guys have watched like my old vlogs in the past before I went to college, I would always go to a place called Hot Works, And luckily, I still have my membership there, and they put all of HotWorks classes on the app. So I'm gonna do one of those downstairs in the basement in our little gym downstairs. So I will film some of that and take you guys along with me.
I never loved you like I love me. I guess I never loved you, and I took care of me. Okay, okay, okay.
So I just finished my workout. All I did today was, well, I just did 30 minutes of hot yoga, and I feel like, I don't know, it didn't feel like that much of a workout, but it was definitely like a nice stretch. And today I'm super sore, like in my leg area because of yesterday's workout, so I may just keep it at that. Okay, so I'm sitting outside in my backyard right now. I wanted to sit down and kind of just be able to tell you guys some ideas that I have for when you're just sitting at home during this like weird, scary time in our lives. It's so easy to just, you know, sit alone and dig yourself into a dark hole. But if you just find stuff to do around the house or even outdoors, there are actually so many things you can do during this time. And so I just wanted to give you guys some ideas that you can do. So obviously this video include some ideas, like at-home workouts is a super good idea because it gets your body moving and it gets your mind into a better place. I feel like if you're up and moving, you're more in the present moment. You're not so anxious about the future or sad about the past. You're just in the present moment, and I feel like it makes you less stressed and a happier human being overall. So I highly recommend that. I've been seeing a lot of people recommending like reading books, and I'm personally not a huge reader. Like, I'm a very slow reader, but I just started reading this one book that I absolutely love, and it's so interesting, and it's something that like I want to read about. So like last night I literally read 70 pages of it, and I was like so impressed with myself because I'm normally not a reader, and it's so hard for me to like sit down and like read a book for that long. But I did it for like an hour last night, and I didn't even like realize that an hour had gone by. The book is called Why Men Love the B Word. I don't know if I'm allowed to say the B word on camera because of monetization and stuff, but girls, seriously read it. It's such a good book, and it really just, you know, it's a self-improvement book for sure. So I definitely highly recommend, if you're a girl, a teenage girl, I feel like every girl should read this book. Highly recommend. Another thing you can do is obviously if you're a student, schoolwork. I know like I at first was procrastinating my schoolwork, but sitting down and doing your schoolwork actually is a great time passer, and it helps you not feel so anxious either because you're occupying your brain and you're doing something. Anything that occupies your brain is great during this time. Another thing, obviously, watching movies. Watch movies that inspire you. Watch movies that make you feel good, that make you laugh. Laughing during this time is super important to stay happy and just be in a good mood, and it helps you kind of forget all the negative things going on right now. Another great thing is listening to podcasts. I just recently started listening to podcasts, I think in like the past year, but they are such a helpful source, okay? There's podcasts to help you improve your life. There's podcasts to make you laugh. There's like sarcastic podcasts you can listen to. Literally, there's podcasts for anything and everything you can think of. So if you ever just feel like sitting and doing absolutely nothing, listen to a podcast. It occupies your brain while you're just laying and chilling in bed and you don't have to do anything else except for listen. Another thing, listening to music. Like, just lay down and listen to music. It actually is way more relaxing than you think. Like, I feel like we're so used to living these busy lives that we rarely ever just sit down and listen to music, but it is such a good thing, and it makes me feel so good, and it just allows you to kind of like reflect on your life and what you want to change and improve. And yeah, it's a really good thing. Another thing is spending time with your family. And if you aren't able to be with your family right now, FaceTiming your family, FaceTiming your loved ones, FaceTiming your friends. This is a great time to work on your relationships with people that are important in your life because, you know, there's no excuse. We don't have the excuse of being too busy with work or our schoolwork or anything going on because there's literally, we can't do anything. So working on building your relationships with your family and friends and loved ones during this time is amazing. I have personally loved, you know, just being able to like chill with my parents, even when it's like my dad helping me with my homework. Like, I treasure those times, and it's great to be able to do that during this weird time in our lives. So definitely take advantage of that. Another idea is, I don't know like how safe hiking and stuff is right now, but if you're able to like go outdoors in nature where nobody else is, I highly recommend. Like right now I'm sitting outside in my backyard and it's honestly just, it feels so like cleansing and peaceful to just be outside in nature and not like stuck inside my room indoors. Being able to like go outside makes you feel more free and like just makes you realize that like there's more to life than like social media and your bedroom and Netflix. Like being outside just makes me feel a lot better and more at peace with everything that's going on right now. Another thing is journaling. You can just write down how you feel. You can do creative writing. Write down stuff that's happened to you that you want to be able to remember and look back on. Like one of my favorite things is, oh, also this, going through old journals, if that's something you've ever done, and like reading what you wrote back in like 2016. It's just so funny to like see what your thoughts were and what you thought was like the end of the world, and now it's like your life is so different. It's just fun to kind of like reflect and look back on that. Looking back on old pictures, old videos, reflecting on your life, and kind of taking this time to realize what you want to change, realize what you want to improve. Use this time, take advantage of it to self-improve yourself, and find a hobby during this time. Even if it's cooking brownies with your mom or something like that. Just like any little thing, any little hobby, pick it up and start working on it now, because why not? There's no better time than now to find something that you love, something that you can become obsessed with, or just anything that makes you happy, makes you feel at peace, it makes you feel appreciative and grateful of life. And yeah, those are just some of my ideas, and I hope that helps. Tomorrow, love you through sorrow, leave me some work. Hey guys, so I just got out of the shower and I don't really have anything else to do on my to-do list, so I'll probably just sit down and watch some YouTube or Netflix or something like that. Like I haven't really sat down and done any of that today. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and then I'll eat some dinner and I'll check back in with you guys soon. Hey guys, so I just finished eating dinner with my family. We had white bean chicken chili, and then I decided to have a brownie and ice cream for dessert. It was dairy-free ice cream. It was with cashew milk, so healthy, you know, kind of. And now after dinner, I just really like to have some tea and chill. I just hung out with my family for like 2 hours, had tea. Now I'm back in my room. I'm probably going to meditate and then watch something funny, and yeah, maybe do some journaling or something and just chill, and probably actually edit this video. Thank you guys so much for coming along with me on a day in quarantine. I know it's not super exciting, but I feel like people are trying to, you know, find things to do and find a routine in being home all night long. So I hope this can inspire you guys to kind of take on some new hobbies and routines while we're all stuck at home. But a good thing to remember is that literally everyone in the world is bonding over this same thing, and we're all going through this together. So you're not alone in dealing with this. We're all dealing with the same exact thing, and we're gonna get through it. But yeah, leave a comment below if you have any videos that you'd like to see during this time, and I love you guys so much. Thank you for all the support, and if you haven't watched my last video, go watch it because it will make you feel good. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah.